down into the area. It's probably where the financial center again. This building was a similar to what's down Navy Pier where they have palm trees and everything else on the inside of it.
Okay, crystal rock.
Yes, you can see holes in the roof. This is back, by the way. Part of ground zero is up here. We'll get closer views of that. And again, you can see all the rescue boats forming down there. Some ground shots from the police department immediately after. You can see all of the paper fires. From the kinetic energy of that building coming down, plus jet fuel. I mean, fires were set, all the small fires were set all over the place. You can see all the paper. This was a churchyard right across. This is St. Paul's Chapel, which is part of the Trinity Church, right across from the Trade Center. Here's some buildings on the side. Look at it on the fire escapes, all on the paper. This is a view before the attacks. Okay. Tower 2, and here you can see the raised observation deck. Tower 1, this is that statue that's in the concourse. Building 5, 4, Building 6, Building 7, World Financial Center over here, and over here is the Battery Park City. That's after. Again, the two towers are gone. Building 5 is obscured here. This is 4. 6 is going to be over the top. 7 is down at this point. 7 is over here. This is bottom level. Okay, now I'm going to take a rest for a little bit and start this up. This is ground zero, again taken from the Port Authority Police. Maybe it's some sound?
No sound. I have to do my thing.
Okay, she's going to do her thing. I should mention in this, about the third slide, you're going to see what looks like a body. It's a bronze statue of an individual, similar to what you have down at Presidential Towers, a businessman opening his briefcase, life-size. But notice, his pedestal is gone. Whatever he was sitting on is no longer there. So he was just, I mean, this statue just blown right off. Well, okay, I'll just go through these then. But this did have a musical background, gave me a rest.
I get any sound.
If you're not plugged into the speaker system through the computer.
No, I want to get sound on the
computer
itself.
Oh.
Keep talking, Jim.
Keep talking.
You know, I'm going to add something if I may, Jim, because
okay.
how Jim and I got really engrossed in our conversation. As Jim mentioned, he worked at the World Trade Center, 75 through 78, was it?
75 through 79.
79. My husband worked at the World Trade Center when he was a college student. He was a security guard at night while it was being constructed. So a security guard had several floors because they would watch to make sure that none of the construction materials were stolen. So, what Jim and I were talking about, my husband knew this building intimately, as you see this piece of flooring, this concrete passed around. He knew how strong that building was. So to watch that building collapse was just unbelievable to him.
Okay, the background music is New York State of Mind. This is a statue. These were taken. Note the dates on the bottom. These were taken again by the Port Authority Police. This is the pile. Notice these were 210 story office buildings. There is no office furniture. What you see there is a pile of rubble of the exterior steel and concrete. And you'll see close-ups again. They found no office furniture. You're talking about steel case filing cabinets? Nothing. aisle there was about 10 stories high. These are side rooms, see the damage to them. Fires that started in the World Trade Center, seven stories underground, parking garage, the Tower 1, Roosevelt has the tombs, and bankrolls on the Tower 1 and 2. Fires that started there, started on obviously on September 11th, continued the week before Christmas. We visited the spot, and we visited Ground Zero that first Christmas. Our families just did that, and we just felt such a part of that fire. And having worked there, I got out of the battery park, looked up to the church, and I saw the two towers, and all I saw was this big red crane. It was needless to say a shock. It's cleaned up a little bit. This is a generation. She wanted a few blocks away. That is a big thing in the Tower 2 attack. It's that plane is almost getting through the building. Plane came in this area, worked its way all the way down to this ring. This probably happened right after the attack, getting the birds, the fires, they had a partial collapse there. Has anyone ever been to Hainesville? Does anyone know where Hainesville is? But I tell people, we stopped there in 2002, just after the first anniversary, and Hainesville makes Hainesville look like a metropolis. There's a single road with about six buildings on it, commercial buildings. There's a regional high school. That's it. It's a mining town. It's in a strip mine area. It's there in nowhere, Pennsylvania. You see, Harrisburg is there. Pittsburgh is up in this area someplace.
It's not there.
It's in the middle.
Okay, yeah.
It's the last upper left.
There it is. There's Hainesville. There's the crash site. You can't see it here. There's a creek that runs through here. And if you'll hand me these stones in. Again, I'll show you something tangible. This came out of the creek bed of Stony Creek, which runs through the grass site. We picked that up in Hainesville, local artisan carpet. This is the moment of impact we just after. This shot was taken by a real estate agent as she was just leaving her house. It occurred on the other side of the hill. She was over in this area. This barn, by the way, is now white. This is the crash site, probably the day after, because they just start to slow. There's still some smoke around this. It could have been the same day. There is a tent or some structure over there. Crash site is there.
One of the programs was saying that that it landed 5 miles from a high school that was in session at the time.
Yes, I mentioned that in my speech on Sunday. That was one of the small miracles. The other small miracle, they were about at the time of the first plane strike on the Tower 1, they estimate there were about between 13,000 and 18,000 people in towers. 15,000 that happened an hour and 42 minutes. Having to walk down the steps, the elevators were walking up. This is an aerial of the grass site again. A few days after, you can see they started excavating, this area, they're burning in the trees. There wasn't too much left. It's a seatbelt. That's a piece of an electronic piece of equipment. There's some pieces of aircraft. The people of Hainesville put up a temporary memorial, and they must be crazed, because what they did is people were looking for the site, and they basically became unofficial tour guides. So they put up a memorial, and we visited the memorial. One of the things, there's a lot of stuff that was, people came up there and just put stuff around. These angels, not a close-up of them, were probably made by school kids. They had the names of each of the victims. And you can see people left stuff there. There's a rosary. You can see some other stuff. Hats. Somebody left a picture of probably one of the victims. Again, something the local school kids did. Yep. Now, simple memorials and some more elaborate. They also did this because so many people were coming and there was no place you needed to sit.